Welcome one and all to the Russian Grand Prix. We're just a stone's throw from the Georgian border here at Sochi as we get ready to begin the race that served up an absolute cracker back in 2015. A last lap collision between Kimi Raikkonen and Valtteri Bottas sparked controversy in that race, so let's hope the racing is just as tight today. It's time to go racing then at the Sochi Autodrome, where the long run down to the heavy braking zone at Turn 2 is one of two DRS zones around this 3.6-mile circuit. The other, of course, down into Turn 13. 18 corners make up a lap here today, with an average speed somewhere in the region of 130 miles an hour. Joining me for today's race once again is Anthony Davidson. Let's talk briefly about Sebastian Vettel. That was a great win in the last race. Can they keep that momentum going this weekend?
There are never any guarantees in this business, but certainly the performance last time out would have boosted their confidence coming into this one.
With that then, let's run through the grid order. It's McLaren in pole position then, and it's Fernando Alonso in P2. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Vettel, Raikkonen, Daniel Ricciardo, and Perez, Verstappen, Magnussen, Grosjean, and Nico Hülkenberg, Leclerc, Ericsson, Carlos Sainz, and Ocon, Bottas, Hamilton, Lance Stroll, and Sergei Sorokin. Hartley and Pierre Gasly rounds off the grid. And with preparations almost complete, let's head down to the track.
Right, let's be patient going into Turn 1. We want to be in a good position for the rest of the race. Good luck.
Zdravím vás ze F261 a dneska vás vítám u 16. závodu 5. sezony mé kariéry F1 2018. Kde startuji z pole position na velkou cenu Ruska.
That's a good start. Keep it up.
Corner cutting. No, ještě jsem zatím neboural, takže na tohle už budu se dát pozor. We'll be right back.
Microsofts. Engine off, engine off. Coming at the end of this lap. Nice overtake. Pit strategy complete. See these tyres through to the end now.
Thank you.
safety car deployed. Slow down and maintain a positive delta. Virtual safety car is deployed. Drop your speed. Our delta is too low and we risk a penalty. Slow your pace immediately.
K bagetě se slušejí tady na to, protože je na Google zahrace, je tam Eko, pak si to má I.
VSC ending, we're going green, maintain positive delta until the green flags. Virtual safety car is ending, maintain your pace until the green flag, VSC ending, wait for... Okay, slow down, slow down. Your delta is negative, which means you are too fast. Reduce your pace. VSC ending, we're going green. Maintain positive delta until the green flags. Green flag. Come in to put on the ultra soft tire. That's the car behind, now on the ultra softs. Fernando is in the pits.
Kurva, penalizace, tak to ne. No, každopádně bych to chtěl v bagetu, tak to chtěl na hrášku, která...
Plus one lap of extra fuel, fuel target, plus
teammate by 7.0 seconds.
5 laps of fuel remaining. Of fuel remaining. What happened? Let me know you're okay.
No tady skutečně dlouho jsem měl sedmičku.
This is your final lap of the race. There's only one lap of fuel remaining.
Nice work, that's P1. Race win, well done.
So, another fantastic victory for McLaren today. And I have to wonder, Anthony Davidson, just what set them apart from the competition here?
Well, time management probably played quite a large role in the outcome of this one. As ever, it's not just about speed, it's all about maintaining that speed consistently over a stint, over a race distance. So being able to keep up the lap times while still being smooth on the controls and gentle on the tyres, that's really where the race was won today.
Our drivers are making their way out for the podium celebrations, and it's going to be McLaren picking up the winner's trophy. Congratulations to the entire team for that fantastic performance. So then, it's time to see how this result affects the Drivers' Championship. It wasn't the best weekend for our championship leader, and their advantage at the top has been reduced. Moving on to the driver of the day then, Anthony Davidson, who would you go for?
Well, he had a great drive today, somewhat unexpected maybe, but I'm going to go for Kevin Magnussen. Quick, clean, and in control. It was everything you could ask for.
On to the constructors then. We saw a dip in form from the championship leaders today. Their lead has taken a significant blow. It was also a strong Grand Prix from Haas F1 this weekend. Fantastic work from the American team to move themselves further up the table. After all that excitement, it's time for a lie down, I think. Thanks for joining us, and goodbye until the next race.
Na to bych musel náhodou tu zkusit hodně vyhrávat. A týmu, co je tady, že to nikdo nebude zdařit. Takže mi to říká, že ale jako šlachtář jsem nic taky nikdy nebudoval. Takže na roce 18. Ale mě to zmanitalo to tak silně. No jedno, že se ta kolečka do první řady, že v tom závodě se jí zmrzí. Než Mercedes, ale I přesto dokážu, že Mercedes už dojde, nebude.
The fans really seem to enjoy that. You made it look easy.
Je to jednoduché, ale...
He took the top points today. Was it a comfortable win?
Bez svého týmu bych to neudělal. Výšší se bude tím metrem, protože nastává poslední kontrakt sezóny.
Another podium. You must be getting used to it up there. What do you think made the difference between this weekend and last weekend?
Něco tady potěšíme, ale to opět aerodynamika, protože se nám dělá jeden poslední upgrade.
We all underestimated you, didn't we?
Vidím rozhodně důvěru. Další zvýšení reputace pro McLaren.
Great! Well, that's everything.
Jdu oslavit! To všechno mě znamená, že se vyrovnávám Fernando Alonsovi a posouvá se před Daniela Ricciarda. Skutečně nastane kontrakt. Je to tak předposlední, protože poté následující bude už na novou sezonu. Kvalifikace naplní, to se mi povedlo. Mám pocit, že
great work this weekend. It was fantastic to see you up on that podium.
Vypadá to, vám pětka neprozradí. Děkujeme, že jste se dívali na tohleto video a zatím nashledanou.